Look at that. It's Thor.
Thor, God of Thunder.
That's right. I never thought you'd listen when Mother spoke of the gods.
I seldom did. Did she speak of one who could feel no pain?
Oh. That sounds like Baldur.
Baldur.
An Aesir god, son of Odin and Frigg.
And Odin is king.
That's right. Why do you ask? I think I see something. Just sitting there in the middle of a lake. It reads, sacrifice your arms to the center of the water. Awaken again the cradle of the world. What? Throw our weapons into the water? Guess that won't be a problem for you. Are you gonna do it?
Saying?
I don't know. There's a shipwreck way over there. See that? And there's a statue of Thor. Except, I can see a lot more of him now.
The water dropped, and the serpent rose.
Oh, that must be why the beach wasn't there before, see? And there's the mountain. Look it, that building leads from the foot of the mountain to that golden temple.
It was all just under the surface.
Except for the statue. Good thing, huh? There's even a dock. There, next to the flag. We're going to the dock first, right? We'll be the first people to walk on it in who knows how long.
You know of that serpent?
He's one of the giants. He's so big, he's wrapped around the whole world and bites his own tail.
An exaggeration.
I don't know. Looked pretty big to me. Oh, good. I was hoping we might explore a little.
When we wish to continue our journey, we know to return here.
What happened here?
Shipwreck.
Well, yeah. I wonder why it crashed.
Amına koyayım şu çocuğu yaklaş biraz.
These rooms. If we find a cipher, I bet I could figure it out. I don't know these rooms. If we find a cipher, I bet I can figure it out.
Ah!
I don't know these rooms. If we find a cipher, I bet I could figure it out. If we find a cipher, I bet I can figure it out. Can we dock here? Hey, look! A torch!
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A brazier. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it? Kavikia.
Learn a
well fought, you two.
What is that?
A spirit.
It's talking to us.
And it hears.
You're dead?
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sather and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm, but we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard.
We have noted.
But...
Whoa! He disappeared!
Come. Let us not be distracted.
guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs. Only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
You will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
Hey, it's another brazier.
I suppose you wish to light it.
Can I? Kvekia. Another spirit.
Yes, another spirit.
Hello.
I can't remember the last time I saw something walk these islands that wasn't dead or corrupted.
What do you mean?
The desolation child plagues this land.
Do you know it's caught?
Not for certain, but...
Do you need anything from us?
Boy,
I only...
What did I tell you about? Offering help.
Don't.
Correct.
But can't we
This is not a debate. You must learn focus. Our journey need be your only concern.
But what if they can help us? That one seemed to know a little about the lake.
And how does that help us with our goal?
We won't know unless we ask.
Thank you.
against something we don't have. I don't think we have what we need to deal with that. Serpent's even over here. I told you he's big. We could beach the boat here. Should we go? Well?
Well, what?
The brazier?
If you must.
Caveggio.
What do you want?
To thank you. These dead weavers drowned me many winters ago, and I've been itching to see them get theirs.
So you died after all the flooding?
Indeed. I came to the Lake of Nine to pillage Tyr's temple, but I underestimated the severity of the desolation.
Have you seen other men? Living? A bearded one, with tattoos.
Only the one standing in front of me. Thank you both for avenging my death.
Useless.
Well, We can't expect them all to know something useful. Cipher. We should look for more like this. Maybe the next one will have more information.
Keep your expectations low, boy. Spirits are rarely useful.
How do they even exist?
When you sever a man from his life, it is not always a clean cut.
So you've met other spirits?
Yes. Many.
What were they like?
Annoying.
Serpent even knows part of his body's lying over here. I can't read these either, but they're different from the others. of the language does. I can't translate this without the whole cipher. I've never seen a waterfall so big.
Boy.
Yes, sir. It's some kind of drawing. Maybe a map? Ooh! Maybe a treasure map.
Good.
God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the gods, Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. He was really thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyesore to the south.
One whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Let his story be a reminder. The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
Something on your mind, boy? Oh, you make up your mind? What you need? What next? Make you something? What's it gonna be? That ought to fix whatever you let my brother do to it. You're winning smiles, armor enough, but why take chances? Yeah, boy? Got something else in mind? That there's quality material. Rate you're going might last a day. Best of luck with all that rampaging.
Hey, Brock. You ever hear of a Dwarf King?
I suppose you're talking about Oatsignir? Bandits ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of you.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you?
Come.
Right behind you.
Bad. Not good either.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyways.
What does it say?
Sir. Veda Dao. It means hunting death. Great.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They're not dead now. Does it matter?
No. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused.
Begin to build statues this big.
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves. We could beach the boat here.
Boy. Boy.